guys, what's up my people? Thank you for clicking to watch my videos. In case you're new here, I go by the name Lucy Gichuki. Please consider subscribing and click on the notification bell so that anytime I upload a video, will be the first one to be notified. And today, because you five of you have requested for me to prepare for your chapati, and I'm not that good when it comes to pastry section, sorry. So he's our chef of the day. He's gonna show us how to prepare chapatis. Let me say soft, nice chapatis, because that's what he does. And let's get to the video, guys.
Before coming back again, guys, to watch the videos, I'm glad. And as you can see, I'm dressed as a professional, but I'm just a quack. I used to work in a hotel, and thanks to that hotel, I have some little skills on
chapatis. No, I'm the one who taught you how to cook chapati.
No, it is in the hotels where I learned.
But see, I taught you. I guess...
You just gave me once.
Yeah, but see that...
Because in the hotel. Thank you, and continue watching and subscribing.
Thank you, guys.
Stay tuned.
Don't miss this.
And so, guys, I also forgot to tell you that we also have chicken. And we are going to cook chapati, ndengu, and chicken. Enjoy. So, we shall start by boiling our chicken. You can see they have already been washed. I'll just add some salt. Then we can begin boiling them. Meanwhile, as we prepare our ingredients. And so, guys, our ingredients for the chapati are here. We have flour, we have salt, and we have some warm water. And we also have sugar, and we have oil. So we shall begin by preparing our flour before we start cooking the chapatis. And this is the most basic way of cooking chapatis. The most simple way. No other ingredients, just the basic ingredients that you may need. And so, because my wife uses measurements, but I never use measurements, I will just show you how much you need. So this flour is the 1 kg flour which I've used, and I've just used almost all of it. I've just been left with a little one, which I will use to roll the chapatis. And so, beginning, we shall use sugar. Sugar, we can use, let's say, 3 spoons of sugar. 3 spoons, 3 tablespoons of sugar. And when we come to salt, the proportionality should be 2 to 1. So we shall use 1 spoon of salt. 1 tablespoon of salt. And so after that, we shall also add some little oil in our flour tin. You can see little oil, because too much oil will make your chapati a little crunchy. They will start breaking as you cook. And then we shall start adding our warm water little by little as we try to mend our flour, so that you don't find yourself using a lot of water and the flour becomes too sticky. Meanwhile, our chicken is boiling, starting to boil, and we shall use chapati, chicken, and ndengu, which means our chicken will be fried, our ndengu will be stewed. And then we shall accompany it with our chapati. Our flour has started to mend up. We shall continue molding until it is ready. You will only know it is ready when it is not any more sticky. It is getting better. You can see it is detaching from the container. You can also see it is detaching from my hands, which means it's getting ready. You can see our flour is getting ready. It's getting much, much better. Until when it is no longer sticky is when you will know it is ready. We shall then mold it over here to make it much, much better. Mold it like this. Let me use here. Not make your flour too hard. Make it softer so that your chapatis can also be soft. You can see our flour is no longer sticky, which means it is almost ready. So we shall also give our flour some minutes just to close it so that it can swell a little bit and ferment a little bit. So as it settles down, we can prepare our pan to start heating up. By the way, so that you can cook well, your pan must be well heated up. If you cook with a cold pan, your chapatis will not be well prepared. So to heat our pan, we shall buy some time our flour to swell. Stay tuned. Yes, when you want to know your pan is ready, you will see it removing some smoke. As in, you can see it smoking up. Our pan is now ready. And now, to start cooking our chapatis, we shall now start making the balls, rolling our balls. And we shall place our chapatis in this basin. But we shall use some serviettes to just cover up and to drain the oil from the chapatis when I place them in it. So we shall just place our serviettes in it, inside the basin, like that. We place it here. Then we can begin making our balls, our chapati balls. And I usually make my balls once so that I cannot have a difficult time preparing them. So to make our balls, I will just roll this one out. And to make it much better, you can do this. To make it have a few layers, you can do what I've just done. And now we shall mend our balls. I will just make some moderate balls. Not big, not small. As you can see. Our pan is very ready. And we shall just begin cooking our chapatis as soon as I roll the first one. And now roll our chapatis. We have our rolling stick here. And to begin, you use some flour on your surface, on your rolling surface or your rolling ball. Then you place your chapati. This is the most difficult procedure, which really, really disturbs many people. And I know many girls out there shall really benefit from this skill. I've tried to teach my wife severally. She is almost there. She is almost there. She taught me the theory, but I taught her the practical. As you can see, our chapati is coming to its shape, perfect shape. You can see shape is perfect. You roll it in a moderate size and then you pick it up and place it on your pan. To know that your pan is ready, when you turn your chapati as I'm doing, it will not stick on the pan. It will not stick on the pan. That shows your pan has heated up well. And so as that one continues to dry up a little bit, we shall prepare the next chapati. We shall roll the next one so that we can save on time. As you can see, make sure your chapati does not burn. You turn it as you continue rolling this one. And you can see this one also has a good size and a good shape again. And so we shall just remove this one and place it aside, the first one, so that it can help me hold the next one, so that we begin oiling them up and frying them up. So that is our second row. We now go to the third one. And I'm sure you're going to benefit from this recipe, from this tutorial. You shall turn this one so that it does not burn up as you continue rolling this one, next one. And as you can see, this one is also ready. And so we shall start cooking, and we shall prepare our oil, place it in a container. We shall place our oil in this container so that we can just scoop it as we go on. I shall place it here closer to the pan. So I will start cooking our chapatis. This one helps me to hold the chapati so that I don't get burnt. So I will just roll it simply, as you can see. You roll while checking whether it is prepared well. You roll while checking, and then you turn it when it is ready. As you can see, it has turned to golden brown. You add oil again to this one on the other side and roll it well in a manner that you can see it is cooking well. Continue checking until it is golden brown, and as you can see, it is now ready. You can see it is golden brown, and then we place it there. Our holding one will still remain there as I heat up the next one, so that I don't get burnt. We shall place the next one on the pan so that it can just heat up, and we continue rolling the next one to save on time. Ready, you turn it when most of the parts are golden brown. Then you add oil to the other side Meanwhile, the first chapati is getting colder, so I will use it to just turn the first, which I've not cooked yet. We'll use it as the one to hold it. So I will place it here, then remove this one that is ready, and place it so that I can cook the one which was first to be rolled. And you can see what I told you, it has some layer because of what I did here. If you want a layered chapati, you can do that. So we shall cook the first one. Now it is ready, both sides. Shall just place it over there. Then we can now continue rolling our chapatis. This is the basic and the most basic way of cooking delicious chapatis. Very delicious. And as I can see, you are already salivating due to only the color. The color is captivating your tongue. And you can comment down below, how do you find my chapatis? How do you find my skills? I've not cooked before in our videos. This is the first video. And you can request any other pastry, any other pastry product, but not complex ones, simple ones, mandazis, samosas, chapati, donuts, simple pastry, typically kibanda. And this dust coat helps me not to dust myself a lot, which is a necessity when you work in a hotel, but in your house you can turn up in any attire. And see, we are almost done. We are almost done. Our chicken is also boiling up. Yeah, and for frying purposes, we don't boil our chicken too much like our chapatis. You can see. Ladies find it very difficult to visit your mother-in-law because you do not know how to prepare chapatis. And when you go visiting your mother-in-law and you are told to prepare them, you begin sweating and you begin trembling. You want to run away from your mother-in-law. But it's not a crime. Not knowing is not a crime, because nobody was born knowing. So it is good you are learning now. It is my privilege to show you this skill. And I know my mother is proud somewhere watching the video. And now that is our last roll, and we shall be done with our chapatis. I don't know how long I've taken, but approximately 20 minutes. Approximately 20 minutes to prepare a 1 kg flour chapatis. This is our last chapati to cook. As you can see, and now prepare our last chapati. I hope you guys have learned how to prepare soft and very sweet and captivating chapatis with little layers. Layered ones, if you want, I can find a day also to prepare them. Some people like three layered chapatis, and I will show you how to prepare the three layered chapatis. And that is it, our last chapati. And that is the best tutorial for cooking the simplest basic chapatis. And now we shall go on to prepare our chicken and dengu stew. Stay tuned. And so guys, these are our ingredients for the dengu stew. I've just prepared my onions, my tomatoes, and my coriander or dania. And to prepare our stew, I will prepare it in the simplest way possible, which includes first frying our onions. Just dry them up so that the oil can just fry them up without water. By the way, dengu is called green grams. Green grams in English. So I'm in the procedure of preparing our green grams. And on this other side, I shall prepare oil for frying our chicken. And so, as you can see, our onions are dried up. So I will just add the oil. I will just add some oil in our pan, our frying pan. This is the pan that we will use to fry our chicken. And that oil is enough as long as some part of the chicken can be submerged, or half of the chicken can be submerged in the oil. Meanwhile, our onions should turn golden brown. And our chicken, as you can see, it is well boiled. It is ready to be fried. I've just placed it here to cool down and to also drain some water. Our onions are ready. After our onions are ready, this is the basic way of preparing dengu, which most of you know. I will add my tomatoes. So adding our tomatoes, we now cook our tomatoes. And on cooking our tomatoes, they have to sweat. Use my lid to cover it up so that it can simmer easily and sweat. Meanwhile, our tomatoes for the dengu are preparing. They are heating up, and we shall give them some time, like 5 minutes approximately. Stay tuned. Thank you. So after 5 minutes, we shall check if our tomatoes are ready. And as you can see, they have overcooked. I will just turn them to make sure all of them are uniformly overcooked. Meanwhile, our oil is getting ready. It's heating up. So I will multitask for today. I will cook our dengu on the other side, and our chicken will be fried on the other side. As you can see, our tomatoes are uniformly overcooked. Not cook all of it at once to avoid them from going bad. So I will use a little bit of it, just enough for us. And this is what I have used, as you can see. I'll just use that one. And to prepare it, I will now turn it so that It is also uniformly cooked and mixes with the tomatoes. As you can see, it looks beautiful. Shall give it like 1 minute. Meanwhile, I will check if our oil is ready. As I was taught, you place your stick, and as you can see, it is reacting with our stick, which means it's ready, and we can start frying our chicken. We shall use this big fork, place our chicken. We shall place like 3 pieces, start by. Make sure the oil does not burn you. As our chicken starts frying up, we shall now add soup in our ndengu. As you can see, it has cooked up, as you can see. Now here is the point where we shall add soup. We shall add some soup, and the soup that we shall use is part of our chicken soup, as you can see. I will begin by adding our chicken soup in it. Then I will add some water so that the soup can be delicious. We'll use the chicken soup. So I will turn it uniformly so that the soup can reach all parts, the taste of the chicken soup. Shall turn our chicken as it fries up so that they don't get burnt. Shall turn our chicken. Your chicken is crunchy before you remove it from the oil. Well fried up and crunchy, so we shall just remove it. Shall just remove it and place it in our plate. You can see our chicken is well crunchy. As you can see, this is the fried chicken. Make sure it is crunchy. Yes. Then we shall place the next pieces to fry up. Shall place all our pieces so that they cook all of them uniformly at once. We shall let them fry up. As you can see, it's well boiled. The stew is very delicious. And then our coriander or dania come in. We just spread them on top of it like that. After spreading them, we make sure it is uniform. We place it like that. Then we let it, the heat that is in the grain grams will cook it. And now guys, some of our chicken is ready. As you can see, they are well fried. They are golden brown. They are crunchy. We shall now remove them. Up. So as you can see, they look so delicious. This one. They look so delicious. Just dry up the oil. As you can see, they are golden brown and crunchy. Make sure your chicken is crunchy and golden brown. To remove it, you can see how captivating they are. And so we will now be done with frying our chicken, and we will be done with today's cooking. And so guys, this is the final product of our chicken.